how a DVD rental company became the internet giant, Netflix. There are relatively few internet users who haven't heard the name of Netflix. This streaming giant has grown exponentially to the point where it no longer requires an introduction. Despite the fact that it consumes hours of our time, Netflix started out as a DVD rental service that was on the verge of bankruptcy. So, where did it all go wrong? What led to such a dramatic turn of events? We break down Netflix's highs and lows for you, so you'll know what led to its current position. The founders. A proud American entrepreneur, Mark Bernays Randolph, was the co-founder and CEO of Netflix. He has started numerous companies throughout his career and has been an investor in a variety of businesses. Randolph was born in New York, the son of a nuclear engineer. He's related to the famous psychoanalyst Sigmund Freud and Austrian politician Edward Bernays through his father's side. As a very active young man, Randolph spent his summers working at the National Outdoor Leadership School. Upon graduating high school, he studied geology at Hamilton College, then took a job with Cherry Lane Music Company shortly after graduation. Randolph handled the mail order operation over at Cherry Lane and learned a great deal about marketing as he went along. Randolph's fascination with user data developed while working there, which later became the inspiration for Netflix's recommendation interface. 2 years later, he co-founded MechWarehouse and MicroWarehouse, companies that handled mail order business. After joining Borland International in 1988, he worked for a few Silicon Valley startups, including Visioneer, Integrity QA, and Adobe Systems. Randolph's impressive career history includes founding no fewer than 6 successful companies, including the famous magazine MechWorld, and mentoring hundreds of startup entrepreneurs. When Pure Atria acquired Integrity QA in 1996, Randolph met Reed Hastings, the founder of Pure Atria, through the acquisition. Wilmot Reed Hastings Jr. attended the Buckingham School in Cambridge and was born in Boston. Shortly after that, he joined the Marines and spent his summer at the Marine Corps base Quantico. Rather than finish his training, he opted to serve in the Peace Corps. As soon as he graduated, he joined the Peace Corps and spent 2 years training in Eswatini, a country in southern Africa, but came back soon after. A few years later, in 1988, he graduated from Stanford University with a master's degree in computer science and joined Adaptive Technology. A year later, he founded his first company, Pure Software, which helped troubleshoot other software. As a result of the 1996 merger with Atria Software, Pure Atria was formed. During his tenure as CEO with this company, he met his friend and colleague, Randolph. But soon after, within 1 year, in 1997, Rational Software purchased their company Pure Atria for a whopping $850 million. The creation of Netflix. On the eve of being acquired, the founder of Pure Atria, Hastings, planned on going back to school, while Vice President Randolph was preparing for the next major launch. As luck would have it, Netflix was that next big idea. So where did it come from? It's quite a funny story. It was known that Reed kept movies far past their release date, and his wife used to get upset when they were charged late fees as a result. A $40 fee was charged to the movie Apollo 13 simply because of this reason. It was Reed's misplaced movie that caused the delay, and he clearly didn't want his wife to see it. To avoid her, he came up with a new business model of purchasing movies online. During a 90-minute drive from Santa Cruz to Silicon Valley, both Reed and Mark discussed this idea. Throughout the next 6 months, Randolph would pitch ideas to Hastings until they finally came up with an idea for a movie rental company that operated by postal mail. Their first step was to head to the music store, buy a CD, and send each other a copy. As soon as the pair received the CD without any damage, they were convinced this idea would indeed work. The pair had a difficult time finding investors in the following weeks, having been rejected over 1,000 times. According to reports, Blockbuster CEO John Antioco laughed the idea off, but the duo stuck with it and refused to give up. Meanwhile, Netflix grew slowly. But where did Netflix get its name from? You can probably figure this one out on your own. To clarify, Netflix is a combination of the words net, as an abbreviation for internet, and flix, a variation of flick, an abbreviation for a movie or film. Pretty simple, really. However, the name did not happen immediately. For example, many names were considered. Replay, DirectPix, Luna, and even Randolph's dog's name, Kibble. The only good news is none of them panned out. Imagine if they had called Kibble and Chill. How bizarre. On August 29, 1997, the couple began the company using Randolph's savings and financial assistance from his mother and Integrity QA founder Steve Kahn. In response to the user data analysis, the company built a subscription model that's still working for the company today. Tests of the early recommendation algorithm called Cinematch proved positive. At first, the company had 30 employees, then slowly expanded. In the beginning, Netflix offered 925 titles and worked on a rent-per-rent basis. September 1999 marked the introduction of a monthly subscription model. One could subscribe to this model and borrow several DVDs, but be relieved of the burden of due dates, shipping charges, and late fees. In 2000, Netflix had over 300,000 subscribers, but was suffering a severe financial loss. As a result, Blockbuster offered the duo $50 million for the company, but they turned it down. About one-third of the company's 120 employees were fired in 2001 as a result of the economic crisis. But good times followed in the spring of 2002, and the business grew. Turned into a giant streaming platform. In 2002, the company made its IPO public by selling 5.5 million shares at $15 per share. During the same year, the company posted its first profit of $6.5 million and had over 35,000 films on hand. Additionally, over 1 million DVDs could be ordered daily from the company. Hastings took over as CEO of the company in 1999, and Randolph gave up his position to focus more on product design and development, finishing out his career in 2003, a year after becoming public. In just a few years, Hastings grew Netflix to the stage it is today, where its value is exceeding $130 billion. In 2005, the company acquired movie rights and was on the verge of going public, but opted instead to focus on a streaming channel, which went public in 2007. During the year 2007 only, Netflix delivered its billionth DVD, and it slowly began moving from DVD to internet-based digital formats. After expanding further by adding streaming media services in 2010, the company also expanded internationally and offers services in Canada, Latin America, and the Caribbean. Netflix began producing and generating content in 2012, and has produced several award-winning series under its Netflix Originals label. Netflix has released more than 126 original series and films by 2016, spreading to more than 190 countries. With revenue growing at 35% every year, Netflix is currently the sixth largest internet company in the world, with over $15.7 billion in revenue. There have also been rumors that Netflix hired a spoiler expert to meet the growing demand. In an interview with Netflix content chief, he stated that people will still watch a show even if it's been spoiled. What a strange concept. A technology called Special Socks was designed by Netflix that would automatically pause the video while it read a viewer's heartbeat. Netflix has come a long way from being a company that barely existed to what it is today. And along with that growth, it has faced constant challenges along the way. Netflix has an amazing company culture that makes every employee want to join. All employees receive free membership as well as unlimited vacation days, among other benefits. Where else could one find a better combination? Despite this, the secret to Netflix success lies in its constant evolution and adaptation in response to those challenges. It started out as a movie rental company, became a streaming giant, and now produces award-winning content monthly. Netflix currently has over 209 million subscribers around the world in 2021, making the future look bright for the service. There were 31 Primetime Emmy nominations for Netflix, including top honors in outstanding drama series, comedy series, and documentary or non-right special categories for House of Cards, Orange is the New Black, Narcos, Ozark, and The Square. Netflix became the first internet television network to be nominated for the Primetime Emmy, and won more awards than HBO, which had been receiving the honor for the past 17 years. Not only that, but they also hosted their own award ceremony called the Flixies back in 2013. However, their return is still not confirmed. In fact, They beat Google's record for generating internet traffic by 0.6% in 2019. Netflix charged Disney a whopping $300 million to stream its movies and shows before Disney Plus was released. The warehouses of Netflix have also remained hidden from the radar and are not indexed on maps, owing to their high value. There's no question that these employees are sworn to secrecy and that their trucks move undercover. We would be foolish to assume that Netflix cannot weather the storms ahead, since it's weathered so many storms before. Netflix success stems from its commitment to understanding its users' preferences, providing the best experience, and simultaneously adapting to the innovation era. We hope you enjoyed the story about the big multimedia giant, but if you want to see more examples of similar exponential business models, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to stay updated for the future. Be sure to like the video too. Thank you.